in the persons of Joe Mantle with me.
Anything is possible in this atmosphere. For I got to do anything. Anything is possible.
Anything is possible
in this atmosphere. For our God is
more than able.
He can do, yeah. Impossible is possible.
Possible is possible
in this atmosphere. For our God is more than able.
sing it again.
Oh, Almighty, Yahusheni, there is nothing too hard for you.
Hey. Somebody lift your hands if you want a miracle in this place.
Jesus. Do you believe that there is nothing too hard?
How many know about the name of Jesus? How many know demons tremble at the name of Jesus? Every knee shall bow and tongue confess that Jesus is Lord. Amen.
Can you feel it? Can you feel it in the atmosphere? Praise the Lord. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Live from ICGC Christ Temple East in Accra, Ghana, this is Greater Works 2021. Let's put our hands together and celebrate the victory of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. What an awesome God we serve. Amen. Now, wherever you are tonight, whether in person here at Christ Temple East, in our churches gathered in various temples, or joining us through our various online platforms, this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. On behalf of conference hosts, Dr. and Mrs. Otterbill, the presbytery and the entire leadership of the International Central Gospel Church, I welcome you to the opening night and communion service of Greater Works 2021. Greater Works runs for 3 days, tonight, tomorrow night, and Friday's anointing service at 6 p.m. each night. Let me quickly remind all of us to strictly adhere to the COVID-19 protocols carefully put in place and speak to the ushers if you require any assistance. We'll start tonight's service with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Shall we have the video introduction?
A multiple award-winning non-denominational choir touching lives through their renditions of African choral music and Western classical music across the world. Greater Works 2021, bringing us a repertoire of classical hymns. Let's welcome Harmonious Chorale. Celebrate the Lord as they come.
Of his power and glory. Amen. And this is also day 40 of our 40 days of power. To God be the glory for the testimonies, the miracles, the breakthroughs that God has showered upon us in this 40 days of power. Tonight is the beginning of harvesting the results of your prayer. And please get ready. Get ready. Don't let anything obstruct you. Tonight, we'll be having a time of intercession, praise, and worship, music ministration, offerings, word ministry, And to crown it all, communion service to open the night. So we will be welcoming Reverend Samuel Awukujechi and the Reverend Richard Osaibonsu to lead us in intercession.
Oh, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You want to stand on your feet, somebody? Hallelujah. We've had a good 40 days of power. I guess you all agree with me. If you agree with me, do a big clap and a shout offering to the Lord for victory. Amen. Now, because of that, we are going to thank God for his power that has sustained us throughout the 40 days of power. We have no choice but to give him all thanks. Lift up your hands and let's all thank the Almighty God for what he did even throughout these days. At a point, you felt weak, but you pressed on. The grace of God was available. He took us through. He gave us good sleep and strength. And today, we all stand in his presence, giving him glory and thanks. We thank you, Father. We give you all the glory. We give you praise, Lord. We thank you for your power that has sustained us. We give you all the adoration. We bless you for the provision of strength during this greater works. And we know that as we go ahead, you are going to be with us. In Jesus' name, amen. You also want to honor the Lord for the manifestation of all his promises towards us. Thank him for his faithfulness and the answers to our prayers, even beyond our imagination. I believe strongly that God is going to do more than we have believed him. God is going to do more than we have trusted him to do. Lift up your hands in faith. And begin to thank him. Thank him for what he's about to do. Lord God, we thank you. We give you glory. We thank you for the days ahead. We know that you are going to show us your glory in a very unique way. Amen. Give the Lord glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We continue our prayer. And we want to dedicate, Greater Works 2021 to the Lord. You want to ask him to manifest his presence and his glory in the atmosphere, and you want to ask him to do mighty works amongst us. The Lord will do a miracle in your life. Kindly lift up your voice and begin to pray to one to you, Lord. We dedicate it to your glory. We bless you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We ask you to preside over this conference. Let the atmosphere be filled with your glory. Let the atmosphere be filled with your presence, with your power. In the name of Jesus, do mighty works in our lives, O God. Let there be miracles. Let there be miracles. Let there be signs. Let there be wonders in the nations of the world. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we ask, O God, that you will fill the atmosphere with your presence. Fill the atmosphere with your glory. Fill the atmosphere with your power. Let there be miracles. Let there be manifestation of your power, of your presence, of your glory. In the name of Jesus, in our lives, O God, in our families, O God, let there be manifestation of your glory and power. Let your presence fill the atmosphere. Let your glory fill the atmosphere. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the glory of the Lord, the presence of God, the power of God will fill the atmosphere. We thank you, O God. We give you all praise. We give you all glory in Jesus' mighty name. This evening, you want to ask God to speak to you. This week, God will speak to you and will inspire your faith for greater works. You will do greater works in your life. You want to pray that the good work that God has begun, he will perfect it in your life. He has begun a good work right from the first day of 40 days and power, and he will perfect it in your life. Kindly lift up your voice and begin to pray. In the name of Jesus, we ask you, O God, that you will speak to our hearts throughout this week. This week we will hear your voice. Your voice will be clear. You will refresh our soul with your spirit. In the name of Jesus, you will inspire our hearts with faith. According to your word, we will receive faith to God, faith to press on, faith to move on, faith to do greater works in our lives. In the name of Jesus, faith to accomplish much. In the name of Jesus, we will receive it, O God. You will inspire our heart with faith. Your word will inspire faith in us. In the name of Jesus, and we will press on. We will press on. There will be great accomplishment in our lives, oh God. You will speak to us. You will give us direction. You will lead our path throughout the week. In the name of Jesus, you have begun a good work of healing. You will perfect it. In the name of Jesus, every good work you have begun, we trust you to perfect it so your name will be glorified. If you believe God has heard your prayers, celebrate your victory in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Lord. If you're ready for a new thing in your life, give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Let me clap your hands in the floor.
The mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Everybody say,
you are the mighty God.
Hallelujah,
the great I am.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
good to me.
God, you've been so good to me.
And I'm thanking you for life.
Name, make known his glory among the nation. Ladies and gentlemen, for the grand opening performance of Greater Works 2021, let's welcome Harmonious Chorale and the ICGC Hymns Choir. Celebrate the Lord as... Give praise to the Lord... Proclaim his wondrous name, make known his glory among the nations. Ladies and gentlemen. It's now time to appreciate the Lord with our giving. Bringing us offering exhortation for today is the regional overseer for ICGC Accra South and senior pastor of Calvary Temple, Reverend Anthony Kujo. Special song ministration will be by the Greater Works Contemporary Choir. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause as we receive Reverend Anthony Kujo.
Hallelujah. Oh, you can give the Lord a better shout and a scream. Amen. The scripture teaches that whatever things were written before were written for our learning, that we through the patience and the comfort of the scriptures might have hope. There's an example of a church in the scriptures, the church in Philippi, that the Apostle Paul had too much to say about them concerning giving and receiving. And I want us to just look at a few things Paul said concerning this church, then take a clue from them and take our offering tonight. Amen. I hope you are here. These greater works. Say opportunity. Now, the Apostle Paul said from verse 15, then I'll come to verse 10. He said, now you Philippians know also that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church, no member, no Christian, nobody shared with me concerning giving and receiving, but you only. Say amen. So tonight, you and I want to be the only. For even in Thessalonica, you send aid once and again for my necessities. But then he said, not that I seek the gift, but I seek the fruit that abounds to your account. In other words, the things we do for God are credited to us in an account up in heaven. But then when you come to verse 10, he said, but I rejoice in the Lord greatly that now at last, say now at last. Last year we didn't get this opportunity, but now at last we have got it. Now at last you've gotten the privilege. He said, now at last your care for me has flourished again. Though you surely did care, but you lagged opportunity. And tonight I want us to see this moment as an opportunity. Opportunity to make the best encounter with God. Opportunity to sow our seed. And I want us to open our hearts and sow into this atmosphere and give unto this conference, and also to sow a seed that is going to unlock that which you have believed God for all these 40 days of power. Say amen.
Amen.
So tonight, we are going to receive the protocol for the offering, but I want us to do something. There are many of us here that are moved to see this opportunity to go beyond what you want to give tonight, to prepare yourself for a special seed. And I want you to call this the seed of opportunity. And you can do 5,000 Ghana, 2,000 Ghana, 1,000 Ghana, 500 Ghana. Tomorrow, take your own envelope. Between tomorrow and Friday, and if you can do it tonight, apart from the envelope that you have been provided, take advantage of this opportunity. Opportunity sometimes can be 2 seconds, sometimes it could be an overnight, sometimes it could be 5 minutes, and tap into something out of this conference and look at how God is going to turn this unto your favor. So I want us not to lack opportunity because it's been offered unto us. And we want to be the people who communicated to the apostle, to the work of God concerning giving and receiving. Say giving and receiving. Say opportunity. Say opportunity. So tonight, you are going to bring out your seed. to take advantage of the opportunity that is available to us. Then the other ones, tomorrow to Friday, you can come and just make that thing available. Amen. Shall we now watch a brief video giving us the various offering protocols?
Thank you for committing to give to the Lord. Here are a few protocols for those in person as well as those of you watching on our various broadcast platforms. For those of you here in person, find on your seat an envelope giving you the details of how to give your offering. The digital giving options on the envelope are displayed on your screens for the benefit of those joining us online as well as those here in person. Please take note of the various channels.
Shall we now pray? Father, we thank you for this opportunity you have given us. Opportunity to appear before your presence, in person and online. But we pray in the name of Jesus that the seed we are sowing tonight and the special opportunity seed we are going to offer will come to you as an odor, so refreshing. Then we can tap into what Paul said, and my God shall supply all your needs according to the riches. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we now receive song ministration from the ICGC Contemporary Choir as we give our offering?
So
Tomorrow evening at Greater Works 2021. Pastor Mensah Otabi.
Praise the Lord. That was a reminder that tomorrow ministering will be Pastor Mensah Otabi. Well, if you just joined us tonight, welcome once again to the opening night of Greater Works 2021. Coming to you live from ICGC Christ Temple East in Accra, Ghana. Let's put our hands together for the Lord. What a great time we've had so far. We'd like to specially welcome our viewers on Joy Prime TV, as well as our churches watching us in various temples and all other online platforms. Why don't you put our hands together for them? Get ready to be blessed in the presence of the Lord. A quick reminder to all of us to keep observing the COVID protocols that we are observing strictly so far, and speak to the ushers if you require any assistance. It's now time for song ministry, after which we'll receive the ministry of the word and partake in the communion service. Let's have the video introduction for song ministry.
Her distinctive voice and incredible range of music genres are God-given gifts she consistently deploys to honor the name of Christ. Greater Works 2021, bringing a song ministry. Let's welcome Sandra Houston Kelly. Celebrate the Lord as she comes.
There at the start, before the beginning of time, with no point of reference, you spoke to the dark and fleshed out the wonder of a light. And as you speak, a hundred billion galaxies are born in the vapor of your breath. The planets form. If the stars are made to worship, so I can see your heart and everything you've made. Every burning star a signifier of grace. If creation sings your praises, so will I. God of your promise, you don't speak in vain, no syllable empty or for once you have spoken, all nature and science follow the sound of your voice. And as you speak, 100 billion creatures catch your breath. Pursuit of what you said, and it all reveals your nature so alive. I can see your heart in everything you say. Every painted sky, a canvas of your grace. You so alive. If the stars are made to worship, so alive. If the mountains bow with reverence, so alive. If the oceans roar your greatness, so
morning devotional, Word to Go, to his scriptural insights in Time with Pastor Otobi, and his inspiring sermons on Sundays, he keeps impacting lives across the world through the ministry of God's Word. Tonight, at Greater Works 2021, get ready to be inspired, to be liberated, and to be equipped for the days, the months, and the years ahead. Bringing us God's Word and ministering in the communion service, ladies and gentlemen, let's rise to our feet and give glory to the Lord as we welcome the founder and general overseer of the International Central Gospel Church, Pastor Mensah Otabiu.
Somebody give praise to the Lord God Jehovah Almighty, the ruler of the universe, our King of Kings, our mighty warrior, Jehovah Almighty, the Holy Spirit, our comforter, Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him be all glory, honor, dominion, majesty, and power forever and ever and ever. And somebody shout hallelujah. Praise to the name of the Lord God Almighty, and you may be seated in God's presence. What a gathering of God's people. What a gathering of God's people. God has been so good to us. You're welcome to Greater Works 2021. And we want to welcome those of you who are blessed to sit outside. The blessing is yours to enjoy the fresh air. So let's celebrate all those who are sitting outside. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. What a day. What a day. What a day. You know, last year we couldn't gather, but thank God for grace and mercy that we can gather this year. When we were planning this year's Greater Works, we said, let's do it very quietly. Let's not advertise. So you can see there was very little advertisement, no billboards, not on TV, because we didn't really want a lot of people to attend. We just wanted a small celebration to honor God. And today when we came in, I saw by 4 o'clock, I hear this auditorium was already full. Some of you are very aggressive. You came in by 2 a.m. The place was full. And then I saw the crowds gathering outside, and I couldn't believe it. And I saw all these vehicles packed outside. And I said, what if we had advertised? But God is showing us that he's able to do more than we can ever ask or think of. And God is just telling you there are things you haven't planned for, you haven't worked hard for, but it's going to happen anyway. It's going to happen anyway. You say, Lord, I don't even want so much. And God says it will happen anyway. Somebody say it's going to happen anyway. The breakthrough is going to come anyway. The favor is coming anyway. The abundance is coming anyway. The multiplication is coming anyway. The increase is coming anyway. The barrel is breaking anyway. Your cup is overflowing anyway. In the name of Jesus. You didn't expect it, but it will happen anyway. You haven't prayed hard enough for it, but it's happening anyway. You didn't fast and ask for it, but God says, I'm doing it anyway. It's happening anyway. And God is exceeding our expectations. So tonight is the end of our 40 days of power. When Jesus ended his 40 days of fasting, it ushered him into the power of his ministry. I believe God is ushering us tonight into power, into signs,
into supernatural outbreaks in every area of your life. You believe it? Say, I receive it. We started our 40 days of power on the 26th of June. And today is the 4th of August. We conclude the fast. 4th of August, a new beginning. And we're going to formally end our fast today by partaking in Holy Communion. And that will be the formal end of our fast. From tomorrow, you can eat. I know some of you have been eating. So you go back to your normal. But for those who have been fasting for these 40 days, tomorrow you can go back to your routine. Don't overeat. Take it slowly and slowly and slowly and get back to your routine. During this time of prayer and fasting, we have prayed as individuals. We have prayed as prayer teams. We have prayed as families. We have prayed as churches. We have prayed as Christians. We have prayed with our understanding. We have prayed with our spirit. We have struggled with our flesh and our appetites. And may God receive our prayer as sweet-smelling sacrifice before his throne. May the prayers we have prayed be as incense that rises to the throne of grace. And may the Lord watch upon the desire of your heart and do for you more than what you have asked for in Jesus' name. So today we stand as a body united in Christ Jesus with one faith, one Lord, one Spirit, one Father. We are gathered together here as it was in Acts chapter 1, in Acts chapter 2, where they were gathered together with one accord in one place, and suddenly they heard a heavenly sound. May we hear a heavenly sound in this place here tonight. And I pray that we will return as Jesus did, in the power of the Spirit, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. We receive the peace of God. We receive the joy of the Lord. We receive divine healing. We receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. We receive favor and increase on every side. By the power of God's Spirit, receive the answers to your prayer. Because of the special circumstances we are going through on our planet with COVID, there are arrangements made for us to be safe. So as you can tell, all our seating is distanced appropriately, and all of us are wearing our face masks. I am the only one not wearing because you are all far away from me. But I was wearing it on my seat before I got here. Because of that, we had to shrink our service time. Normally, this would have gone to a few more hours, like 4 hours. But we are working a two-hour schedule. Everything seems to be short, because we have to obey the rules available now. But in these 3 nights, I will be the preacher. Normally we have guest preachers, but also because of the circumstances, we are not able to have all our guest speakers, so I'm speaking for all of them. I'm speaking for Pastor Matthew, I'm speaking for Bishop Okonkwo, I'm speaking for Bishop Tudor, and I'm speaking for Mensa Otabo too. So I'll speak today, I'll speak tomorrow, and then I'll speak the final night. The final night, Friday, will be our anointing service. You don't want to miss that. So Friday night is going to be super in this place. And each night I will be preaching from the same scripture. My text is going to be from Joshua chapter 10. And I will preach from Joshua chapter 10 today. I will preach from Joshua chapter 10 tomorrow. I will preach from Joshua chapter 10 on Friday. And I will be preaching from different aspects of Joshua chapter 10. And I have titled my message tonight, Just in Time. Somebody say, just in time. Many times in the Bible, we see that God operates a just in time delivery system. He gives us what we need when we need it, not before we need it. There was no need for a ram when Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac. There was no need for a ram ahead of time. But just in time, when Abraham was about to sacrifice Isaac, the ram showed up. Many times when we trust God and pray and believe God, we want to see the miracle ahead of time. But God brings the miracle just in time. At the appointed time, at the appropriate time, just when you need it, it shows up. So don't get worried when it delays, because God has a just in time delivery system for you. And may the Lord give you a just in time miracle. When God gives us a just in time miracle, it appears as a sudden work, as if it just happens suddenly. When you think it's too late, he shows up. When all the doors have been shut, he opens them. And may the Lord give you such a visitation. So I'm going to start reading from Joshua chapter 10. And I'll focus today on verses 5 to 9. But I'll give you a background to the story before I read it. Joshua has taken over the leadership of Israel from Moses. Joshua was a military man, an army man, an army general, a warrior. And his task was to ensure that the children of Israel got to the promised land and each of the tribes got the land that has been promised them. So when he got to the promised land, he started occupying the land so that the promise of God would become a reality. The first battle he fought was the famous one we are all familiar with. That was the Battle of Jericho. And then after that, he went to fight the second battle, the battle with Ai. And they disobeyed God, so they lost that battle. And then they fought a third battle with the same city of Ai and won it. So we can say that at this time, they have fought two major cities, but three battles. Now, when the people in the surrounding area saw what was happening, in the first place, the Jordan had opened, they had come through, Jericho is falling, Ai is falling, they just decided, let's go make peace with these people. So one of the tribes in the area, or one of the cities in the area called Gibeon, decided that they would go to Israel to make peace. They went to Israel and made peace. They told a lie that they were traveling from afar. As a matter of fact, they were traveling from very close. But they said they traveled from afar. And Joshua said, okay, we will not conquer you because you come in peace. Later, they realized that the people had lied. When the other kings in the area heard that Gibeon had gone to make peace with Israel, they decided to go and fight Gibeon, wage war against Gibeon. And the Gibeonites, who now have a peace treaty with Israel, went to Joshua and said, "By the way, after we signed the peace agreement with you, five kings have come against us and they want to fight us because we signed peace with you." And Joshua decided to side with the Gibeonites and fight this battle. I'm giving you all of this background because it is key to the message I'm going to preach. So with this background in mind, we read from verse 5 to verse number 9 of Joshua chapter 10. And it reads, "Therefore, the five kings of the Amorites, the king of Jerusalem," at this time Jerusalem was not the capital of Israel, "the king of Jerusalem, the king of Hebron, the king of Jarmuth, the king of Lachish, and the king of Eglon, gathered together and went up, and all their armies, and camped before Gibeon, and made war against it. And the men of Gibeon went to Joshua at the camp of Gilgal, saying, 'Do not forsake your servants. Come to us quickly. Save us and help us, for all the kings of the Amorites who dwell in the mountains have gathered together against us.'" So Joshua ascended from Gilgal, he and all the people of war with him, and all the mighty men of valor. And the Lord said to Joshua, "Do not fear them, for I have delivered them into your hand. Not a man of them shall stand before you." I feel that is God's word to somebody tonight. "Do not fear them, for I have delivered them into your hand, and not a man of them shall stand before you." Verse 9. "Joshua therefore came upon them suddenly, having marched all night from Gilgal." My focus in this passage is the verse 9. "Joshua therefore came upon them suddenly, having marched all night from Gilgal." When you read this story, you ask yourself, why did Joshua bother himself to fight this battle? Because after all, the Gibeonites had lied to him. Why did he decide to fight a battle that was not his battle? Well, it was his battle by extension, but it was not his battle directly. Why did he get involved in this battle? Because this battle was a strategic battle. Why was it a strategic battle? God had promised Israel all of the land. The strategy they had had was take one city at a time. You take Jericho and you take Ai. In Ai, you fight two battles actually for one city. But this time, five cities, almost all the major towns and cities came together. So Joshua therefore strategically considered, instead of waiting to fight one city at a time, if all of them have come together, then I better take advantage of this opportunity, because with one victory, I'm going to conquer five cities. You know, sometimes when all your enemies gather together against you, it is a strategic moment for God to give you a victory that has a far-reaching consequence than taking on one enemy at a time. If you feel yourself surrounded by many enemies, they have joined together against you, I have good news for you. It is a strategic alliance for a strategic purpose. So sometimes God will bring you strategic battles to fight. Those strategic battles seem like a big threat, but they are also strategic opportunities. And strategic battles of that nature do not come with announcement. It just piles up against you. One pops from here, the other pops from there, the other pops from there, and all of a sudden you are surrounded. Yes, it looks like a threat, but if you see it like Joshua, it is God's opportunity. I believe that in our lifetimes, we will fight many of such battles. As a matter of fact, we are engaged in one of them at this time. It's called COVID. I believe COVID is a strategic battle we must fight and win. It's not just the health battle, that's the easiest one. But the total disruption that COVID has brought to the entire world. Reduce everybody to the same level. At the beginning of this COVID, I said that this was the finest moment for third world countries, nations like Ghana, previously despised. This is our moment. Because whenever there is a major systemic disruption, the winners are not the major people. The winners are the minor people. It was in the midst of such a major systemic disruption that David emerged as king over Israel, because Goliath disrupted Israel. It disrupted King Saul. It disrupted the military system. No general could fight until one shepherd boy emerged and took down this giant and saw his promotion. So what we see as disrupting the world may become our stepping stone to greatness. I was very excited when at the beginning of COVID, we were all very excited about getting inside, doing things by ourselves, producing our own masks, producing our own raw material. And then after some time, we said, let's go back and import. Let's go back and import. Let's go back and import. We are just about missing a strategic opportunity. If outsiders seize the moment, they will emerge the winners. So here is Joshua in the battle, defending the Gibeonites who had lied to him, but he has a sense of honor to fight for them, not because of the Gibeonites, but because he can see the finger of God in this battle. So when he heard about it, he decided to go into this battle. But he did the most unlikely, probably unrealistic thing. Because if you are one army, Israel, and you have five armies against you, you want to face the five armies in your strongest form, refreshed, energized, not tired, not weak, not hungry. But Joshua started from Gilgal, and the passage says he marched all night. How do you march all night to go and fight an enemy who has been sleeping all night? Because if he's been sleeping all night, he'll be stronger than you, he'll be better rested, he'll be better focused. Your army will get to the battlefield tired. But that's what Joshua did. All throughout the night, they were marching. They were marching. They were marching. The troops were tired, but they were marching. No sleep, no food, no rest. Marching. The enemy was sleeping. They were marching throughout the night, throughout the night, throughout the night. The night in the Bible represents many things. It represents uncertainty. It represents weeping, pain.
It represents isolation. So Joshua and the army are marching throughout the night. They can't even tell whether they are making progress or not. They can't see anything to tell them you are moving forward. All they're doing is keep marching and marching and marching and marching. They have no food to eat, but they are marching. They have no encouragement, but they are marching. They are isolated, but they are marching. And they are marching through the night when others are resting. They are working in the night. They are marching in the night. Others are enjoying, but they are marching in the night. Some of you feel that way in your life because you feel that your life is a long march in the night. You've been marching. For us, for the last 40 days, we've been marching in the night, praying and fasting and praying and fasting and praying and fasting and praying and fasting. And then somewhere along the line, your body is tired. You feel like breaking your fast. You feel like going to eat something. You feel like catching up and building your energy. But you keep praying and fasting, and people are eating and eating, and you are praying and fasting and marching. For some of you, you feel your whole life you've been marching and never arriving. You've been working so hard, but never reaping the fruit of your labor. You've struggled so hard to make it, but you never make it. You've prayed year after year after year after year after year. Keep marching in the night, in the dark. Nobody sees you. Nobody praises you. Nobody encourages you. Don't stop marching. Don't stop praying. Because just in time, suddenly, there will be a shift. So the Bible says that as Joshua was marching throughout the night with his army, a tired army, suddenly they were upon their enemies. And I suppose that the enemies were still asleep. They came upon them suddenly. Somebody say suddenly. The Hebrew word is pit'om. Suddenly. It means something that happens very quickly. The word is used in various parts. In Psalm 64 verse 6 and 7 it says, the psalmist is talking about his enemies, and it says they devise iniquities. And whilst they're devising iniquities, they say, we have perfected a shrewd scheme. Both the inward thought and the heart of men are deep, but God shall shoot at them with an arrow. Suddenly they shall be wounded. In Isaiah 48 verse 3, it says, I have declared the former things from the beginning. They went forth from my mouth, and I shall cause them to hear it. Suddenly I did them, and they came to pass. Pit'om, suddenly, something that happens at the right time, an act of God. So that's what happened. They've been walking through the night. It looks like it's a useless walk. It's a bad strategy. It's a non-productive strategy. But just in time, something happened. I believe we are in such a moment in our lives. One moment you are in darkness, the next moment you are in the light. One moment you don't know where you are going, the next moment you have arrived. One moment the enemy has the upper hand, the next moment they are knocked out cold. One moment everybody has left you behind, the next moment they are all trying to catch up with you. That is God's just-in-time delivery system. In Joshua's case, both Joshua and the enemy had a suddenly. Joshua's army is marching in the night. In the night.
It's almost like, you know, you're climbing a mountain, you're climbing a mountain, you're climbing a mountain, you climb and climb and climb. Then you get to the mountaintop and suddenly you see a totally new picture from what you saw before. So Joshua's army, by dawn, upon their enemies. The enemy also had his own suddenly. He's sleeping, he's comfortable, we have the numbers, we have the advantage, we have the victory, we're going to win this one. These people are new, they don't have experience, we'll get them, we are more than them. Let's sleep, let's relax, tomorrow we'll get them. Then suddenly, Joshua appears. Both of them had a suddenly. The night before, there was no sign. The next morning, everything changed. I came here just to speak to some people who have been marching in the night. You've been marching in the night. It's been a night march. A night march. For some of you, there is one prayer topic. You've been praying your intestines out, your heart out, your liver out, your lungs out, your throat out. You are pulling your hair, and it seems as if nothing changes. But suddenly, there will be a visitation. What if God had given Hannah a child when she prayed for a child the first time? We would never have heard of her, and we would never have heard about the child. What if God had given Elizabeth and Zachariah a child the first month they married? We would never have heard of them, and we would never have heard about John the Baptist, and we would never have heard about his ministry. But just in time, suddenly, when all of them thought, this thing is not going to work, I've done it over and over and over, God shows up and suddenly it happens. The thing about God's suddenly is that it is not suddenly. It just doesn't happen. It happens after a long march in the night. That's why sometimes people look at you and say, where did you come from? All of a sudden, you are all over the place. All of a sudden, you are prospering. All of a sudden, you're broken through. All of a sudden, they think you are Johnny just come. They think you just appeared. When you were marching in the night, they never saw you. When you were toiling in the night, they never saw you. But God saw you. God saw your prayer. He saw your toil. He saw your desire. He saw your effort. He saw your night vigils. And when nobody was watching, he sprung it over them. That's God's just-in-time delivery system. After a long walk in the night, just before Joshua got to that point, God said to him, don't be afraid, Joshua. I have given this thing into your hand, and no one can stop it. There are things that God has put in your hand, and no one can stop it. They may have power, but they can't stop it. They may have privilege, but they can't stop it. They may be more armed than you, but they can't stop it. They may be more in number than you, but they can't stop it. Because what God has given you in your hand, He has put in your hand. And throughout the night, when they were walking and pushing on, I'm sure one soldier will say to the other, where are we going? We don't know where we are going. Does Joshua know where he's going? We don't know. All we know is, this night, we won't sleep. We are marching. And the next moment, it was all different. I am a full believer in God. I don't know about you, but I believe in God. I am a full believer in divine purposes. I am a full believer in Africa and its destiny and its future. I am a full believer in the black race and our dark skin and the purpose for which God made us dark and put us on this continent. I'm a full believer that God does not make mistakes. Because as an African, sometimes you wonder, when will it be day? We've been marching and marching and marching and marching in the night. Today is Founders Day in Ghana. We've been marching in the dark since those guys were around. We've been marching in the dark when our ancestors were taken as slaves on slave ships. Many died in the process. It was dark. Then we were colonized. It was dark. Then we gained independence. We thought it was light, but it was dark. Kwame Nkrumah said, the independence of Ghana is meaningless unless it is linked with the total liberation of Africa. The total liberation of Africa came, and we were still marching in the night. Even South Africa that we all thought was going to show the way is marching in the night. So sometimes as an African, you look around and you say, will this march ever end? Will we live to see our hope become a reality? We will get out of the mess and the darkness. I am a believer in Almighty God. I am a believer that God does not make mistakes, and God does not create mistakes, and God does not put people in a place for a mistake. Everything God does is for a purpose, is for an assignment, and His purpose is for good and not for evil. His purpose is for good and not for evil. So I announce to you, Africa, you've been marching in the night. It's been a long march. We don't know when the march is going to end, but I know from Scripture, one day, one morning, God's in time, just in time, delivery system will be handed over to us. And suddenly, there will be a change in the story. Somebody say, oh, that is just a fantasy. Everybody thought China was a fantasy. They march in the dark since their dynasties. Darkness, darker than us. Darkness, darker than us. But just about 50, 40 years ago, suddenly, they are overtaking the United States of America. If it can happen to them, I suggest to you the God of purpose, who doesn't make mistakes with any group of people, who doesn't discriminate against any people, who doesn't disadvantage any people, that same God, the God of the nations of the world, we are coming out of our darkness. I said we are coming out of our darkness. And not only are we coming out, you are coming out. I said you are coming out. There are some of us who have never smiled before. You will smile. You have never rejoiced before. You will rejoice. You have never lived in your own home before. You will live in your own home. You have never had your own money before. You will have your own money. And some of you have been sick for a long time, in the dark, marching, fighting sickness and disease. I announce to you, God is delivering you from that sickness. Your healing will spring forth in the morning. So today we affirm our faith in God. Somebody say, I believe in God. We affirm our faith in God's purpose for our continent. Somebody say, I believe in Africa.
We affirm our faith in our race. Somebody say, I believe in the black person. And we affirm our faith in God's purposes for our lives. Somebody say, I believe in my future. 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 I will not be a failure because God does not create failures. I will not be a disappointment because God does not create disappointments. I am marching in the night. I am marching in the night. I am marching in the night. The enemy is mighty, but I am marching in the night. I am believing in the night because suddenly, just in time, I will arrive. Just in time, I will arrive and God will fight for me. Tonight, on this first night of greater works, God wants to tell you, your march in the night is taking you somewhere. Somebody say, I'm going somewhere. Say, I'm going somewhere. I'm going where God wants me to go. Say, I will arrive. Say, I will arrive. I will arrive. I will arrive. Say it like you believe it. Beat your chest and say, I will arrive. I will arrive. Just in time. I will not miss my time. I will not miss my moment. I will not miss my season. I will not miss that day. I will arrive. Just in time. For all the prayers we've prayed in these 40 days, may the Lord bring us out of the night and cause us to arrive. For all the fasting we have fasted in these 40 days, may the Lord take us out of the night and bring us to the day. For all the meditations of these 40 days, may the Lord bring us out and surprise our adversaries. They will have a shock. They will have a shock. The person they thought was finished will start. The person they thought was last will be first. The person they said there is no hope for him will give them hope. The person they laughed at, they will laugh with. I said they will laugh with. They will laugh with you. Because the Lord will fill your mouth with laughter. Tonight, just before we partake of communion, just lift up your hands to God and pray for our continent, Africa. Pray for Africa. Inkosikelele Africa. God bless Africa. Bless her people. Bless her leaders. Bless her men and women. Bless her children. Bless her land. Bless her hard work. Bless our activities. Bless Africa. Bless our going in and our coming out. Establish us, O Lord. Establish us, O Lord. Deliver us from reproach, O Lord. We are marching in the night. Lord, help us to arrive. Now lift up your hands and pray for yourself and say, Lord, help me to arrive. It's been a long journey. Help me to arrive. It's been a long, dark journey. Help me to arrive. Help my children to arrive. Help my husband to arrive. Help my wife to arrive. Help my father to arrive. Help my mother to arrive. Help my aunt to arrive, and my uncle, and my cousin, and my nephews and nieces. Just begin to talk to God. It's a long walk in the night, but we will arrive. In the name of Jesus, every delayed blessing comes into its fulfillment. Every frustrated dream sees the light of day. Every dead intention gets a resurrection. Suddenly it is Sunday morning. You had your Friday and you were crucified. But Sunday morning is coming. It's called resurrection morning. There may be a seal on your tomb. There may be guards on your tomb. But there is going to come a shout from heaven. They can't stop it. They can't delay it. They cannot deny it. Because it's happening. Somebody say, Lord, bless me. Oh, cry to the Lord and say, Lord, bless me, like Jabez. Cry to the Lord just as we get ready for communion tonight. Pray and say, Lord, bless me. Lord, bless me. Thank you, Lord. You just may be seated in God's presence. There is an atmosphere of breakthrough in this place. Jesus went to the pool of Bethesda. And there was a man lying down there. He's been there when there was a stirring of the waters, but he couldn't jump into it. Tonight there's a stirring of the waters, but you will jump into it because your helper is here. You have a helper, and he's called the Holy Spirit. That man said, no one, I have no one to help me. Tonight there is somebody here to help you. He's called the Holy Spirit. And in this stirred atmosphere, he's going to take you and put you into the flow. He's going to take you and plunge you into the streams of living water. As we get ready to partake of Holy Communion, for all the things you've been believing God for in these 40 days, just talk to the Lord about it. Just talk to the Lord. Meditate on those. Because as we partake of communion today, there will be a delivery system sent to you. A delivery package is coming to you. An assignment has been given to angels to be dispatched to your address. They will not miss you, and you will not miss them. Receive God's blessing and visitation tonight. In the name of Jesus, we proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. God's season of delivery for his people. And if you are partaking of communion with us on TV or online, get ready as we bless these emblems, that as we partake of them, they will minister to us the body and the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, O Lord, King of the universe. Blessed are you, the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us life and given us all things by your Spirit, who has given us the earth, out of which comes this bread and this wine, and that which we hold in our hands. Today, Father, as we partake of this table, we set apart
this bread and this wine from normal usage, that as we partake of them, they will minister to us the body and the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I give to you that which you have received, that the Lord Jesus Christ, the night on which he was betrayed, he took bread, and after he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body which is broken for you. Eat this in remembrance of me." The same manner also he took the cup and blessed it and said, "This is the new covenant in my blood. Drink all of it. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show forth my death until I come. Do it in remembrance of me." Today I want you to take your bread. Take your bread, lift it up. And say, "Heavenly Father, I receive today the body of Christ that was broken for me, the body of Christ that was wounded for me, and I receive today healing, restoration in my body. I receive also today the body of Jesus Christ that was raised for me, that as I partake of this bread, you will lift me up, you will raise me up, you will set me on high. You will cause your favor to rest upon me. Bless me tonight. Cause me, O Lord, to enjoy your blessings of heaven on earth. In Jesus' name." The body of the Lord Jesus Christ, take and eat. In the same manner also, you took the cup, blessed it, and said, "This is the New Testament in my blood." Say with me, "Lord Jesus, I receive your blood that was shed for me. Your blood is my covering. Your blood is my weapon. Your blood is my victory. I overcome by the blood of the Lord Jesus and the word of my testimony. And so I declare today, I am coming out of the night. I am coming out of the night into the day, into my victory. And I receive tonight the full blessing of the blood Jesus, of the blood of Jesus upon my life." The blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, take and drink. May the same resurrected Christ lift you up and fulfill his purpose in your life. Just rise up and just worship him this evening as we thank him for this fellowship.
Your presence, there is nothing you cannot do. I stand amazed in your presence. There is joy, peace, and hope. I stand amazed
in your presence.
There is nothing,
nothing
you
cannot do.
I stand
amazed in your presence.
There is joy.
Jesus, no one
And so, Father, tonight we proclaim that we are coming out of the night. We proclaim freedom for Ghana and for Africa. We proclaim historical economic growth for Ghana and Africa. We proclaim the era of Ghanaian and African technological revolution in agriculture, in food production, in industrial development, in scientific innovation, in banking and finance. We announce and proclaim the emergence of Ghana and Africa from poverty and scarcity. We announce and proclaim the emergence of wealth in Ghana and the rest of Africa. We announce and proclaim the emergence of a new generation of captains of industry and owners of wealth in Ghana and Africa. We announce these proclamations over our nation, over our continent, from the north, the south, the east, and to the west. And we declare that throughout the night we march, and suddenly we will see the victory of the Lord in Jesus' name. And somebody shout, amen. Somebody say, just in time. Just in time. God will not be delayed. He will not be late. He is just in time, at the right time, for me, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said, praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said, praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Honor the Lord as if you are crazy in this place. As if you have no head, as if you don't think, scream to the Lord, shout to the Lord, celebrate to the Lord, just in time, just in time, just in time. It's happening live in your life in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Well, we're going to give our second offering. This is a time for you to show your appreciation to God. Sow into this anointing. Release your faith and demonstrate your commitment to see God's goodness happen to you just in time, in this season, in this hour, in this moment. You will see the victory of the Lord. The band will minister as we receive our offering. We thank God for the first night of Greater Works. We'll be here tomorrow, same time, 6 o'clock. You can be 2 o'clock. But let's come and let's worship the Lord. Lift up your hands to the Lord. So, Father, as we have declared, so shall it be. And we declare in this place, at this time, that we are coming out of the night. And just in time, suddenly, what was long will happen. And what we have desired will materialize. So I speak the blessing of the Lord over you. I speak the favor of the Lord over you. The protection of the Lord over you. As you go out in your home, may the Lord keep you safe. May the streets of Accra be safe for you and your vehicles. May your home be safe. May your children be safe. Walk in the strength of the Lord and return in the power of the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Tell the person next to you, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.
Ministering tomorrow evening at Greater Works 2021. Pastor Mensa Otabiu. Greater Works 2021 with Pastor Mensah Otabiu. Wednesday 4th to Friday 6th August at Christ Temple East, Deshi. 6 p.m. each night. Greater Works 2021. Bigger, better, and greater.
Just look at somebody quickly, say, he is great and he is mighty.